in the praise. I feel anointing in here. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. While you're praising God, turn to Psalms 143. Psalms 143. Hallelujah, Jesus. Psalms 143. And we're going to read a little bit of David was praying to the Lord. And we're going to read a little bit of what David was saying. Say hallelujah, Jesus. And I want you to realize something. You got to praise. You got to glorify. You got to lift him up. Say hallelujah, Jesus. He's a mighty God. Hallelujah, Jesus. And God good. Hallelujah, God. Read in Psalms 143:1. David was praying to the Lord. And he was having a talk with God. And David said something that stuck out to me. Say hallelujah, Jesus. And made me get Jesus, give God some praise for a son Jesus. Because it wasn't for Jesus Christ. Yes, sir. And obedience to the Father. I wouldn't know what I'd be doing right now. Say hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. When you have to say amen.
Amen.
Hear my prayer. Yes. O Lord, this David prayed. Yes. Give ear to my supplication. Yes. In thy faithfulness. Yes. Answer me. In thy faithfulness, not in David's faithfulness, but God in your faithfulness. How many know God is faithful? How many know God will come to your rescue? How many know God will heal you? How many know God will deliver you? How many know God will set you free? God is faithful. God is faithful. First thing you have to realize, God is faithful. Look at your name and say, God is faithful. God is faithful. And whatever he promised you, he going to do it for you. But now, first thing David said, Lord, David was praying, and he said, hear my prayer, O Lord, give ear to my supplication. In thy faithfulness. Now, it ain't because I've been doing good and because I've been acting right. Look at David pouring directly to God. In your faithfulness. In your faithfulness, God. Answer me. Say hallelujah, Jesus. A lot of times we want to pray, we want to tell God what we did and what we didn't do and how we acted. And I want you to get something because I want you to learn how to pray. See, when David went to God, he said, God, in your faithfulness, not in my faithfulness. He went to God talking about, Lord, I've been reading my Bible, I've been going to church, I've been doing the best I can do. God, he didn't go to God, but he said, God, but in your faithfulness. See, God, you are faithful, God. See, because I don't know, we have been faithful sometimes. Sometimes we don't pray enough. Sometimes we don't act right. Sometimes we don't do right. But David didn't go to God talking about himself. David went to God talking about God.
Amen.
When you go to God, you got to know how to go to God. God in your faithfulness. In your faithfulness. Answer me. Sometimes we say, God, answer me because I did this, I did that. God, I've been going to church, I've been paying my tithe, I've been giving my seed for this. No. In your faithfulness.
Yes.
Because even though I obeyed you, came a time when I didn't obey you.
Amen.
It came a time when I didn't do what you say. So I can't come in my own accord. I got to come in your name and in your power.
Amen.
In your faithfulness.
Glory to God.
Yes. Y'all in the house. But in that righteousness, not only your faith in your righteousness, in your righteousness, not myself righteous. Not because I went to church. Not because I go to church. Not because I pray. But because of you. Because of you, God. God, I need you. I come before you, God, because you're faithful. You're faithful in your righteousness. God, you're a good God. You're a mighty God. You have all power in your hand. You set the stars in the sky. God, you move by your power. You created man from the dust of the ground. In your righteousness, in your faith, everything you made is right. Everything you do is right. Everything you say is right. In your righteousness, you're the one that made me righteous. I'm not righteous of myself. Oh, help me somebody.
Hallelujah.
Listen to what it says. And enter not into judgment with thy servant. Oh, my God, don't judge me. Don't judge me. Otherwise, you make God judge because you tell him what you've been doing, what you ain't been doing. But David said, Lord, don't judge me.
Come on now.
But in thy sight shall no man live life, be justified. Oh, my God, no matter what I did, the way I went, no matter how I act, no matter how good I've been, no matter what I've done, I still feel short of you, of your righteousness and of your glory. Because you're such a mighty God and awesome God. God, I never can equal up to you. I never can stand before you with my eye looking you eye to eye. Because I know, God, that you are greater and mightier than I am. And I can ever be. He humbled himself under the mighty hand of God. And said, God, I can never be like you.
Amen.
I can never be as good as you. 7 days a week, and you'll never interrupt them. Why have you made this church atmosphere about you? His presence is in here because he knows it's about him. See, you should have had a prayer life before you came to church. When you went in your closet, you said it's a praise. And when you prayed, you should have believed that you already received it. So when you get to church, you got praise on your lips. Because I prayed in my car. But I come to my church service is to come to lift him up. But then there's a lift him up. Not to lift you up. Not to make you feel good. But to know he is good. Somebody, you can come to church, or did you come to God? Did you have a praise on your lips, or did you come because of hope? Did you come because of situation? But did you come to God? Him that come to God, like the first, know who he is. He is faithful. Listen to what David said. He's faithful, and he's righteous. He's not wrong with me. So if I get somebody's righteousness on me, if I get somebody's glory on me, he'll make the foot and roll straight. It wasn't about the song. It wasn't about the crowd. Hear my heart, it ain't about the crowd. It ain't about how they look. It ain't about what they say. It ain't about what they do. It's about him. Come on now. Did you come to lift him up? Did you come to praise him? Don't you let your surroundings affect you. Don't you let your surroundings take your focus. Don't you let them make you get in the situation that they move in. Don't you let them get in the room that y'all won't shout at the God that they move in their presence. They God ready to bless you. But your flesh gonna get to deceive you. We God ready to bless you. God ready to bring you up. God is faithful. God's able to deliver you and set you free. God ready to set you free. God ready to deliver you. God ready to prove it. Don't you learn to take your power.
Hallelujah.
For God is faithful. Never leave out of the presence of God the same way you were before you came. When you come to praise him, when you come to lift him, folks come for different reasons. They come to get some, I come to lift him up. You already heard my prayer. You already heard my supplication. And I know I can't stand before him talking about me. Y'all in the house. I didn't come to hear the president. I come to hear God. I come to hear the speaker of the house. I come to hear the Holy Ghost. I come to hear the presence, see the feel the presence of God. I didn't come. Everybody know him. He didn't come to the one in the audience, but he come to the one that's up front. He come to hear. When you go to a concert, you don't come to hear the people in the crowd. You come to hear the one that's singing. I came to get God praying and get God glory. He's my keeper. He's my healer. He's my provider. See, I just strip my walk through him. Because it reminds me that I have him. What he is to me. And I begin to look up at my spirit. And my spirit begins to get stronger. And I pray him. And I go about him. And I get stronger talking about you. Or looking at you. Or worrying about you. I get stronger. You know your focus. I didn't come here to text. I can text at home. I can play games at home. I didn't come here to play on my phone or play on my iPad. But I come to lift. because I closed my trousers. My situation of life. And he's with me. He got me. And all I remind myself is when I worship him, when I praise him, I need to tell myself that I'm an angel. Focus on him. But I know the enemy trying to throw me off. I know the enemy don't want me to get the day in my day. The day I get set free. The day I get healed. The day I get my the most righteous and the most powerful God in the universe or anywhere. because you come worship Him. You come glorify Him. You don't come talking about yourself. You come talking about Him. Oh, I am, because you know that I have fell short this week. You know, I have done some things and said some things I should have done this week. So I can't get there on my accord. I got to go through Jesus to get to Him, because I can't go to myself. I did not read like I posted this week. I did not act like I posted this week. So I need a doorway to get in. Y'all with me now? And I'll still come in the house of God without a prayer. See, I still can give it. Look at your lips, I still can give it.
I still can give it.
But the only way I can get it, I got to know who He is. I can't get it, listen to folks. And I can't get it, listen to religion. Because it still got law. I gotta get it from Jesus through Jesus. And then I'll put Jesus and show it on Jesus. But they still say, I can't get it because of me.
Amen.
When Jesus said, if I believe in Him, and if I'm in Him, then I He'll give it to me. But they say they still can't get it because I ain't righteous enough. I ain't holy enough. But they say, God don't judge me.
Amen.
Y'all in the house? Y'all with me? Preacher, he said, I can't get it because I got this going on in my life. But God said, you can have it if you believe in my son Jesus. You can give it if you believe. I can turn your life around. I can make things right in your life. I can change. Only you can change you. Only I can make it right. All you got to do is turn to me and accept me and come to me and let me change you.
Amen.
And when you come as a worship, as a praise.
Amen.
But come as a total word. Worried and frustrated and worried about what people say, how they look.
Amen, amen.
People want things to change their life, but they're too worried about people for what to change. Instead of focusing on God.
Hallelujah.
I come to lift them up. They'll shove them in the church because they ain't do right this week. They cut up by the praise, won't go up in the church, they'll cry. Church, you're quiet because you got so many that didn't do it. And you got a few that did it. But no matter if you did it or not, you still should be praising God. You still should be lifting up God. You still should be glorifying God. Don't let me ask God to do that. My God still who you say He is. God still is righteous. God still is righteous. God is righteous. God is not about it. He shall lie in the head like you saw, but He can't bless you. In the midst of your shame, that God still can bless you. God still can turn things around. God ain't gave up on you. Look at them and say, God ain't gave up on you. God ain't gave up on you. Because you think that way. Amen. Get in my house. behind. Just because you're going through, don't mean everybody going through. Y'all ain't saying that. Because everybody is going through, they ain't accepting that. Some people, brother, they ain't accepting that. You have to accept them going through, they ain't accept them. They say, I'm blessed and have a favor. God moved in my life. God brought me out. God blessed me. God knew. You the one that got accepted, you going through. It's hard for everybody. No, it is hard for you because of the way you believe. Oh, help me somebody. You remember I'll tell somebody their heart, you'll get all the way to them because they believe in one, you believe in another. You can't tell me their heart. No, I can't tell you because that's what you believe. And you keep believing like that, Jesus Christ can't set you free. Oh, help me somebody. Your believing that got you trapped in a trap when God can set you free. Who he set free is free indeed. How could you go back into the bondage when Jesus can set you free?
Amen.
Oh, help me somebody. Somebody don't know what setting free is. You don't went back in the bondage because you spoke yourself in the bondage. You don't want to stay at home. He said, my God, you need my better life. So how did you get what God got for you when you said what you going through is hard, it can't be God? Because he said, my God, believe y'all ain't catching it. People said, my God, believe my brother and God. So how you going through something hard? It ain't got nothing to do with God then. Y'all ain't saying much. Because if you have something to do with God, you say, God, thank you, Jesus, easy here. And you speaking it by faith so it can get easy. You speaking it by faith so it can turn around.
Amen.
But you want God to come in with some stuff when you ain't speaking his word.
Jesus.
Y'all been out?
Amen.
Don't leave me yet. Brother Galatians 3 and 22. Say hallelujah to Jesus. Ain't gonna do it. Now we come to God because of him, not because of ourselves. Ain't that right?
Amen.
He moving by the power. He bless you right now. Ain't that right?
Amen.
He ain't judging you. He ain't criticizing you. Criticize yourself. You know you're your worst critic. You lose your praise, you said it because of God, because you upset him, but you did it because you upset yourself.
Jesus.
You were disappointed in yourself, that's why you lost your praise. Because without God, you still be praising.
Amen.
But you lost your praise because you thought you should have stood when you done fell, but God's still on the throne.
Yes.
So you talking about what God doing to you when God ain't doing that to you. You doing it to yourself. Y'all with me?
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When you gotta say amen.
Amen.
This is what the scripture said. But the scripture has concluded. All under sin. Y'all hear that? All under sin. Y'all see that? All everybody. Ain't nobody exempt. You know what I'm saying? You get it to me, do you? Galatians 3 and 22. Y'all with me? That the promise by faith, say
by faith,
of Jesus Christ might be given to them that believe. Say believe.
Believe.
So the scripture has declared that everyone is sin, but you can't be saved but only through Jesus Christ. Sin is just spit out your life only through Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the house. So all way to get through God to God is through Jesus. Y'all in the house? Y'all got that? Say hallelujah, Jesus. Come agree with that.
Amen.
So you can be sin-free if you believe in Jesus. Because we all sin, have sin, fell short. All of us sin was sinners. All of us at one time was sinners. Yeah, that. All of us at one time was sinners. But since I believe in Jesus Christ, I'm not a sinner no more. But people say, I still sin. No, you say, that's what you call it. I can't be a sinner because if I'm a sinner, I can't be a Jesus. I can't be a sinner and saved too. I gotta be born again.
Hallelujah.
I gotta be born. I gotta be born out of the incorruptible into the corruptible. I came out of corruptible, but now I'm in the incorruptible. I've been born again.
Amen.
So now in Christ Jesus, there's no sin in Christ. In sin in Christ.
No.
So how can you be a sinner and saved?
Amen.
Oh, y'all ain't saying I'm a sinner, but I'm saved. How can you be a sinner and saved?
Come on.
Jesus came to fulfill the law. He didn't come to get the law was for man, but he came to fulfill. believe is to be saved through Jesus. Say believe, say faith. Faith is something serious. See, according to your faith, according to what you say you believe, according to how you act, is the kind of how you live. That's why you still look when you mess up and just not pleasing God, and you look at his sin. See, the difference is sin and just not pleasing God. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. Can I help you? It's the difference in sin and not pleasing God. They are not the same thing.
Amen. Glory, glory, glory.
But I call it sin when I didn't please my Father. So I continue to say it's sin, so I won't get it right.
Jesus.
But who want to continue to disbelieve the Father when he's faithful, when he's getting ready to bless me, when he's getting ready to move in my life, and he's ready to do great things in my life, and I'm still a sinner when I'm supposed to be saved, and I just not pleasing him.
Jesus.
So I'm not looking at it as a relationship, I'm looking at it as a law.
Hallelujah.
It's a difference in a law and a relationship.
Yeah.
If you do it because of that law, it's a difference when a man stays with a woman because of the law. That's a miserable life. He come that we have life and have it more abundantly. He didn't come that we be miserable.
Come on
now. So when you come up with one of the law, you do it because you obey your Father.
Jesus.
So who wanna keep?
Come on now, you worthy.
I heard him too. I keep right on blessing you.
Yes.
And you keep disillusioning me. But I keep right on blessing you. I'm a faithful God. I keep right on moving in your life. See, that's what folks don't understand about God. He keep right on blessing you and keep moving on you because you are, you say you belong to him. Because you look at it as sin, but he look at it as a relationship. He look at it as love. I got to go before him in church. And I got to face my daddy with praise and worship. When I don't, and I keep doing it wrong, like he ain't got the power to deliver me. So now when I look at sin, it weakens me. But I look at the relationship, it strengthens me. I got to get it right. I got to turn it around. He said, I can't keep going to my daddy and tell him something. How are you doing? It weakens me.
Oh, my God.
Thank you,
Jesus.